One thing that I'm pretty sure is popular among the people I represent is having a larger paycheck at the end of the week. And so this is part of the reason, right, to marry individual side of the tax code reform with business reform. We have both. We absolutely lower the tax burden on middle income, working class families. People will see in a few weeks that their take home pay has gone up because the withholding will have gone down. That'll be pretty dispositive, I think, for most people. And I do think we're going to see a wave of growth, a surge of growth and new capital investment, especially with the reforms that we're making on the business side. So I'm very optimistic.
You think reconciliation tied in a perfect world? Do you think reconciliation tied your hands to some extent? Because I was just trying to do the math in my head. If the corporations are going to benefit, obviously it's going from 35 to 20. So that creates revenue that needs to be replaced. So when you do the individual side, it almost seems like a given that there are going to be people. You can't do tax cuts on individual and on corporations.
Yeah, well, no, sure you can. Sure you can. We had an instruction, a budget resolution that authorized through the reconciliation device that we could forego $1.5 trillion without taking into account the extra economic growth or the expiring provisions in the tax code. That sounds like a big number. It's just a little over 2% of the revenue that the federal government is projected to take in. But it did allow us to build in tax savings on both the business side and the individual side. You're absolutely right. The reconciliation is a tough box to have to live in. Believe me, we've been living in this for quite some time now. For instance, there's all kinds of policy changes we'd like to make, but they simply don't qualify for a bill that gets this procedural treatment, and it creates hurdles for us in terms of budgetary impact outside the 10-year budget window. So we've got all kinds of arcane rules that we have to live with. But Joe, as you know, the alternative was the Democrats would have killed this by filibuster. They told us that. They have no interest in this bill. So we had no choice but to use a device that would allow us to pass it in the Senate with a simple majority.
But you need salt. You need to get rid of that.
Right.
To pay for things. And I can just tell you that in New Jersey, in New York, in California, that there's these are people that are probably even higher than the 1%. They may even be above that. But there are people whose taxes are going to go up significantly that are going to be for the greater good. And maybe that's the right way to do it. But it reminds me of tax proposals that President Obama would have put forward, where the people at the top are going to pay. They can afford to pay a little more. And do you want to know some of the people in New Jersey and New York?
Believe me, I'm getting plenty of phone calls, Joe.
Hundreds of thousands. Some people are going to be paying a 5-10% more in tax. And that's
well,
fine.
First of all,
go ahead.
You haven't seen the final product yet, so hang on. Will there be some outliers who pay more in taxes? Yes. Will they be people? Yeah, like, you know, Joe, you're an outlier.
I'm sorry, but you're an outlier. We're outliers.
There's a few things to keep in mind. I've just acknowledged, right? There are some people who will pay more because they live in very high tax jurisdictions, and we are going to significantly limit the ability to take that deduction. But that's not the entire story. We also move brackets. We lower rates. We have a terrific tax reduction for people who have pass-through income, you know, the big majority of American businesses,
Senator,
that are not C-Corps.
Senator,
all of those things are helpful.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.